This is Shubhanka here from Quantsapp. Welcome back to another video. So now we are going to launch a series on basics of F&O segment purely in English, wherein we are going to discuss some terminologies, some basic concepts with related to futures and options segment from the basic till the advanced level. So I'll just give you out an heads up what exactly we are going to discuss in the series. So first we'll try to understand what are futures contract, what are options contract, then what is a call option, what is a put option, how the premium of a particular option has been calculated, what is strike price, then moneyness about the options. Then we will take the series to an advanced level wherein we will try to simplify the complex option terminologies like put call ratio, implied volatility rank and percentile, and taking it to the end to a much more advanced level, we'll try to discuss some of the strategies and none but not the least the option Greeks as well. So do stay tuned with us. So talking about this video, so in this video we are going to understand what are derivatives. So futures and options contract, as we all know, they are a type of a derivative contract. Okay, so what exactly they are? They are a type of derivatives. So now first we need to understand what exactly derivatives are, then we can understand futures and options in a much more better way. So let's try to simplify as we do it at Quantsapp, and let's try to understand what are derivatives with a practical example. So let's say, let's read out the definition first. So what are derivatives? So derivative are financial instruments which derives its value from an underlying asset. Okay, so there are two critical sentences or words out of the entire definition which I have segregated. So the first one is financial instruments. So let's understand what are exactly financial instruments. So financial instruments, I would say, are something which can, you know, be traded financially, as simple as that. So in terms of market, it can be gold, it can be stocks, it can be bonds, it can be debentures. All these are financial instruments which are traded. So these are my financial instruments. Now the second sentence is derives its value from an underlying asset. So financial instruments out here, they are deriving its value from an underlying asset. So what is an underlying asset? Underlying asset can be, again, it can be stocks, it can be index, it can be currency, it can be gold again. So those are my underlying asset, wherein the financial instrument is deriving its value from its underlying. Okay, so might sound a bit complex, right? So let's take a practical example and understand, and then make it a bit simpler again. So let's try to take a practical example. So there are two products. So first one is milk, the other one is milk based products. Okay, so as simple as that, as and when the milk's prices go up, at the same time the milk based products like butter, like paneer, it can be ghee, the milk based products, even those prices will go up. Another example, let's say there are two products again. First one is gold, the other one is jewelry. Okay, assume that the gold jewelry out here, it is purely made of 10 grams gold. Okay, so 10 gram gold is right now pricing at 50,000 rupees. Similarly, the 10 grams of jewelry which is made of gold, it would be also quoting at somewhere around 50,000, let's assume 60,000. Now let's say 10-15 days down the line, when gold's prices go up from 50,000 to 60,000, at the same time jewelry's price from 60,000 will be raised up till 70,000, right? It won't be the case wherein gold ka price is going upwards and the jewelry's price are going downwards. If the gold's price are increasing, the jewelry's price will also increase. So the idea is very simple. Gold is an underlying asset, jewelry is my derivative product, because jewelry is deriving its value from its underlying. And what is the underlying? It is gold. So as and when the prices of gold goes up, jewelry's price will also go up. As simple as that, derivatives are nothing but a type of a product, a secondary product which is deriving its value from underlying. So now let's try to check how we can relate this thing with stock market and how these things work in stock market. Let's say there are Reliance futures contract, there are Reliance options contract. Okay, now Reliance's share becomes our underlying. Okay, now as on when Reliance's share price, which is Reliance's underlying price, it goes up, at the same time, Reliance ka futures contract ka price will also go up. It won't be the case wherein Reliance ka share price is going down and Reliance ka future prices are going upside, right? It would be always having the linear payoff system out there, wherein if Reliance's share price go down, at the same time its derivative contract, which is its futures contract, its price will also go down. As simple as that. So coming to a conclusion, what are derivatives? So futures and options are type of a contract which are deriving its value from the underlying. So what is underlying? Underlying is our share price, our index, our currency. Okay, so in this scenario, underlying can be index or stock. Okay, so futures and options are deriving its value from the underlying assets. That is the reason why it is called as a derivative segment. That is why they are derivatives, but not a primary product, not an underlying. So yeah, I would say that was it from this particular video, wherein we just had a small gist what exactly derivatives are. In the coming video, we'll try to understand why exactly participants use derivatives to trade and what is their main agenda behind trading derivatives. So to stay tuned, do hit the subscribe button, do hit the bell icon, so whenever we post something, you'll be receiving a notification. Thank you.